Hi guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. My name is Dustin from Laptop Factory. Congratulations nga pala kay Andre Sakilayan. So siya yung nanalo nitong Aorus TV figurine. And then after this video, magbibigay ulit kami ng isa pang ganito. So please stay tuned until this video ends. Para doon sa mga winners, please message us. Ilalagay namin dito yung contact number kung kanino i-claim yung mga prizes ninyo. Guys, this is just only valid for 30 days from the date na nag-upload kami ng video na ito. So kung hindi nyo pa nakuha yung prize ninyo or yung giveaway ninyo, please contact the number. We'll put it down on the description below kung sino yung i-contact. Sayang kasi yung ano eh, unang-una yung Acer table, tapos after this other videos, magbibigay na kami ng tablets and then mga laptop na. So isipin nyo after 30 days kung hindi nyo na ano, so sayang naman, di ba? So guys, sa mga winners nga pala na nag-message sa amin, so please watch this video kung paano namin pinadala yung units nyo. So ayun, nakita nyo naman kung paano namin iningatan yung mga giveaways na yun. There are safe and secured.
There are safe and secured.
Ah! Mabigat siya! So, our next video is Gigabyte Aero 15 OLED. Model is RP75XD. So, ito yung bag niya. So here, when you open the bag, okay. So ganito ang ano sa inyo. Malamang dito ang lagayan ng laptop. And then ano to? Something lagayan. There's the logo of an Aero here. So it's really exclusive for Aero. Okay, so nothing more with the bag. Open na natin tong laptop na to. So buksan na natin to. By the way, mapapansin niyo yung logo ng Aero dito. Alam niyo yung parang sa logo ng PlayStation. Yung X, square, circle, triangle. Mukhang hindi sila nagkakalayo. Okay. Anyways, ano bang meron dito? Ba't malaki? Wait. The laptop is really secured. Pag nakita nyo, hindi ka mag-worry about pagpapadala nito. Kasi talagang, ang laki ng box niya, tapos 15 inches lang naman yung laptop. Okay? So there's a cloth with an Aero logo here. Okay, and then pag ganito, meron another cloth. Pero check na muna natin to. Ano meron dito? So guys, this is running an RTX 3070. So expect the charger na malaki. Ang ano dito is 240 volts. That's 3.5 amperes. 230 watts. Okay. The manuals. And then what's this? Ah, okay. So this is a gel. So ito yung pwede mo ikabit sa SSD mo. In case na mag-upgrade ka ng SSD dito, kinakabit to sa SSD para hindi uminit yung SSD mo. They call this thermal pad. Cooling gel tawag ko dati dito. Alright guys, the AirBook 15. Okay, so the color is black. It's plain black. No accent of other colors. Hindi nga mapapansin that this is a gaming laptop or whatsoever. So, dito sa likod, may makita kayo ng logo ng Aero. Dun sa ilalim, there's also a logo of an Aero. And then dito, yung exhaust fan niya, this is yung heat na palabas. And then meron ditong parang ano, fishnet carbon daw, sabi ko na. And then, at the front, we got here another Aero logo. The webcam is pwedeng buksan, pwedeng sara. Sticker of an i7, RTX, and then some stickers here. I'll not go into details na lang dito. Meron sticker dito na color calibration. So medyo na-intriga ako dito sa sticker na to. Kasi first of all, hindi ko pa binubuksan yung laptop. So it's basically pure black. Pero I'm seeing the light right now reflecting on this laptop. Nakikita ko na bluish yung screen niya. So hindi ko lang kung nakikita nyo rin in your end. It's bluish. It's not like other laptops na color black. Na pag may nagre-reflect na ilaw, color black ang ano niya. Kaya pala tinawag to na Aorus Aero 15 OLED. Probably it's because of the OLED display. So mamaya, i-check natin kung gaano kaganda yung color accuracy ng unit na to. And then, aside from that, what else I could say? There's the power button here and then the speaker, probably here on the side. And now, let's talk about the ports of this unit. So on this side, we do have an HDMI 2.1 a mini DisplayPort 1.4, a USB 3.2, so this is a Gen 1 Type A, and an audio combo jack 3.5mm. Of course, meron din tong ano, yung RJ45 or tinatawag nilang LAN port. On the other side, we got here another two USB 3.2, that's Gen 1 Type A, and then a USB Thunderbolt Type C. So this is a Thunderbolt 4, and then SD card reader and saksakan ng charger. At the back, there's no ports. And then sa ilalim, ayun, makita nyo ang laki ng daluyan ng hangin. It looks like yung figurine nila, yung chibi figurine. The figurine and then its wings. Okay, so the serial number, stickers, nothing more, nothing less, and PC. Now, let's talk about the dimension of this Aero 15. The width is 14 inch, and the depth is, that's 9.8 inch. The height is 0.84 inch. The weight of this unit is 2.3 kilograms, and the viewing angle is somewhat of 110 to 120 degrees. Alright, so guys, let's open this unit and gusto ko na talaga makita yung specs ng laptop na ito. Now, let's talk about the specification of this unit. So, the exact model is Aero 15 OLED. So, the model is RP75XD. The processor is an Intel Core i7-11800H. So that is 2.3 base boost and the turbo boost is 4.6 gigahertz. So this is 8 cores, meaning octa-core, running with 16 threads. The memory is 32 gig. So that's DDR4 3200 megahertz. The storage is 1 tera SSD. The integrated graphics is Intel Ultra HD graphics. So bukod pa yung Nvidia, we'll talk about that later. The display of the unit, the resolution is 3840 by 2160. So guys, this is a 4K display. Halos lahat ng binavlog namin is just, you know, a full HD resolution. But this is a 4K display. So actually, ganito nga yung gusto kong laptop, guys. Yung 4K display, yung as in marami ka talagang ma-open na tabs at the same time. May mga video editors na nagtatanong sa amin na, does this run in 4K video editing? Now, this laptop actually runs, yes, because this renders a 4K resolution. So it's 15.6 inch with a bezeled screen, guys. So this is just like 0.3 millimeter lang yung border nito. And bukod doon, this claims that it comes with a Samsung AMOLED display. Kaya nga yung model niya is OLED eh. With a Vespa Display HDR, so that's high definition resolution, 400 through black, 100% DCI-P3. Just do the research in Google kung ano ibig sabihin nun, and it says here on the specification itself, it's color calibrated. So guys, this is automatic 100% sRGB. So yung AMOLED display na to, actually nakikita lang natin to sa cellphone eh. Pero here, makikita mo sa laptop mismo. Parang meron kang MacBook Pro Retina display on a Windows laptop. Guys, emphasize ko lang yung 4K display na to. The last time that I saw a 4K display was on the Razer Blade. And that was like 4 years ago. So gustong-gusto ko yung screen na yun. Bakit? Kasi andan ko no open application at the same time. So are you seeing this kung gaano kaliliit yung mga screen? I'm not sure kung nakikita pa rin to sa camera. Yun. Tingnan mo yung start button. No? This is for 100%. Pero, of course, ang suggested ni Aorus is the 250%. But on my perspective, gusto ko naka 100% para marami ako na open applications at nakikita at the same time. The video card is NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3070. So, that's a laptop GPU. And that's at 8GB GDDR6. So, hindi katulad ng 3060, it's just only a 6GB. This is 3070, that's why it's an 8GB. Ang TDP nito is 105 watts. By the way, this comes with an NVIDIA Max-Q technology. Alright, keyboard feels. I've done a typing test and I scored actually 42 words per minute. So in the first sentence when I was doing it, medyo tumitingin ako sa keyboard, not on the screen. Kasi parang ginagamay ko pa. And then after the third or fourth sentence, ayun, sa monitor na ako nakatingin sa screen. Probably hindi naman kayo mahihirapan na mag-adjust dito from your computer to this computer when you do some typing, okay? So it's an alphanumeric. It comes with the numbers dito, or numpad. And this is an RGB keyboard, so you can customize the keyboard. And you can actually customize this in the Aorus Control Center.
So right now, I am testing the camera of this unit. So what you're hearing right now is the audio quality of this Aero 15. So katulad ng mga ibang Gigabyte, nasa ilalim yung camera niya. If I look on the screen, so ganito ang makikita niyo sa akin. Makikita niyo yung aking chin. That's why I'm looking on the camera right now. Just like other laptops, standard cameras, 720p, that's 0.9 MP with a 60Hz refresh rate on the camera of this unit.
So guys, we're gonna test this on games because this is running an NVIDIA RTX 3070. So that's an 8GB GDDR6. Now guys, the refresh rate of this laptop is only 60Hz. So expect that probably the max refresh rate that you're gonna see on the games is 60Hz. We're still gonna test it. From the ashes, wings on my back.
These need killing! A slice of the action!
Your bottom tower is under attack. Your middle tower is under attack.
Enemy down.
So high, I'm up above the clouds. So high, I can't see the ground. So high, I ain't coming down. So no, I ain't ever coming down.
Okay, maraming salamat sa technician natin. This is underneath the chassis. Unang napansin ko dito, parang ang laki ng ano niya, ang laki ng battery niya. We'll talk about the battery life of this unit later. And this is a 32GB laptop, so this is a 16 and another 16. So the memory na nakakabit dito is ADATA. And yung storage is 1TB SSD. So ito yon yung SSD. And you will notice here meron yung parang yung cooling gel para hindi uminit yung SSD. And here's another slot of the M.2. Dito kinakabit yung another SSD. So there's no 2.5 SATA here or yung lagay ng HDD. Just sum up, ang pwede mo lang idagdag na lang dito is another SSD. Now, bago nyo ikabit yung SSD na yon, meron sa box na parang yung cooling gel, ilalagay nyo rin siya dito para hindi uminit yung SSD. The fans are here, out ng fans is on this side, and here's in this side, the processor and the GPU are here, and a separate battery for the clock and the time, and the Wi-Fi card. Nothing more to add, so just to sum it up, pwede pa kayo mag-add ng SSD dito. Okay? And by the way, you cannot upgrade this by your own. You need to go to an Oro service center to have this upgrade. So, tabi na natin to. So, before we go to the pros and the cons, tignan na muna natin yung mga sticker na ito. Okay? So, first of all, meron dito all-day battery life na naka-indicated sa sticker na to. As I've mentioned kanina, malaki yung battery niya compared to regular laptops. Meron ditong Wi-Fi 6, faster connection speed, Thunderbolt 4, and then meron dito ng HDMI 2.1, 4K-120Hz video output, at exclusive cooling system, probably that is the tinatawag nilang WindForce, yung Infinity Next Gen na cooling pad, and then supports PCIe Gen 4 storage. Yes, nakita natin yung M.2 slots, and DTX Ultra Audio technology, okay? Alright, so start with the pros. So the pros, first of all, the display is an OLED screen. Hindi lahat ng laptop may OLED screen o tinatawag nilang AMOLED display. Regular laptops is, you know, is either glossy or is either matte. Tapos 300 nits, 100% sRGB. But this one, talagang may pagka-OLED talaga. As I mentioned kanina, pag nagre-reflect siya sa screen ng black, nakikita talaga yung pagiging blue niya. Parang sa mga mobile phones. And it's also, you're gonna notice that in retina display sa mga Mac. I think naman sa Mac naman is color brown pag nagre-reflect sa screen. And this one, color blue. So I think it's leveling on a MacBook Pro retina display on a Windows laptop. Okay? Another pros, of course, this is an RTX 3070, so 8GB, that's GDDR6. If you're gonna ask me kung saan pwedeng applications ang pwede dito, pwede ko na lang ba sabihin lahat na applications pwede. Mas lalo sa mga for video editing and then photo editing. Pwedeng-pwede rin to sa mga AutoCAD. Any engineering softwares, any 4K recording, editing, video editing whatsoever, ayun, kayang-kayang itong laptop na ito. Now, let's talk about the cons of this unit. Ang pinaka-cons na napansin ko dito as a gamer and a first-person player, mababa yung refresh rate niya, 60 Hz. Baka because it's a 4K resolution on the laptop. But don't worry, hindi ka naman mag-stuck forever sa 60 Hz eh. If you're an FPS player, you could use an external monitor. Ikakabit mo lang sa HDMI nito because it's running an HDMI 2.1. So it's 4K on 120 Hz. So if you're gonna reduce the resolutions to full HD sa external monitor mo, I'm pretty sure that you're gonna get a higher refresh rate. It depends on your monitor. If your monitor is capable of 240, 144, ganun, magbubugata ng mas mataas na 60. It's just that pag nag-FPS ka dito mismo sa laptop na ito, parang ang bagal. Kaya if you are an FPS player, you will be needing an external monitor. Isa pang cons na napansin ko dito is the camera, the webcam. Yung webcam niya nasa ilalim, lagi nakikita yung double chin ko. Probably because gusto yung i-emphasize ni Aorus yung 3mm bezel-less screen niya. Kasi pag nilagay mo pa yung camera dito sa taas, of course, mas madadagdagan yung borders ng laptop na ito. They really want to emphasize yung gaano kaliit yung borders niya. Alright, so yung mga target market na tong laptop na to, of course, sa mga content creator and then yung mga high-class na engineer talaga, and then yung mga photo editors na talagang nag-work talaga sa mga corporate, yung talagang mga big-time na photo editors, video editors. Bakit ko sinabing big-time? Kasi baka magulat din kayo sa price nito. So by the way, there's another sticker here that this laptop is made in Taiwan. Para baka mas ma-ease kayo pag made in Taiwan. Okay, for the price of this unit, pag bibili nyo ito sa iba, it's like 130 or 140,000. But here in Laptop Factory and Circuit Base, it's 120,000. But don't worry, kasi minsan hinahagil namin yung price kay Aorus eh. In case na mababa nila ibigay sa amin, bababaan din naman namin yung presyo na ito eh. And sometimes, we do sale time to time. So I suggest that you follow our page on Facebook, that is Laptop Factory with 500,000 likes. So sana 500,000 likes na rin yung YouTube natin, eh, no? Para happy-happy tayo. Okay, you could actually purchase this in our store nationwide. We do have store listed at the end of the screen. And in case na ayaw nyo umalis due to this pandemic, of course, may mga taong ayaw talaga umalis sa bahay nila. We do cash and delivery naman nationwide. If you're here within Metro Manila, it's our own carriers. Pag Visayas, Mindanao, it's through LDC. Of course, pag mas malayo, mas matagal ang delivery time frame. But if you're here in Metro Manila, sometimes it just to take 1 to 2 days to deliver the unit. Mode of payment, it can be a cash or it can be an installment. Installment, meron kami home credit sa store, and then in case na hindi ka makapunta sa store and gusto mo ng installment, we do have this Bill Ease. You just go to our Laptop Factory website and then there's the Bill Ease instructions on how to apply installment ng walang credit card. Okay, the warranty of this unit, it comes with a 1-week replacement. Anything happen, kware, pag-deliver sa'yo, may sira agad. Palitan agad namin yan, walang problema doon. And then after that, in case na, kware, 5 months, 6 months, or 1 year, wag naman sana, masira yung unit nyo. This comes with a 2 years Aorus warranty. So you could go to any Aorus service center para ayusin yung unit. And also, upgrade the unit in case na gusto nyo magdagdag ng SSD pa sa laptop na ito. So guys, please don't forget to like and subscribe to our page. Because if you follow the steps by liking this page and then subscribing to our page and sharing the video to your social platform, pwedeng ikaw ang manalo ng giveaway. So after this video, we'll be giving a chibi figurine. In order for you to avail some of our giveaways, guys, simple lang. Number one, like this page. Number two, subscribe to our page. And number three, share this page to your online platform, if either Facebook or Instagram. We do have this computer or randomizer na namimili kung sino nagpa-follow ng protocol na yon. And pag ginawa mo yon, pwedeng ikaw ang manalo ng giveaway. Okay? So, yung mga nakakuha na, may chances pa rin sila manalo. Hindi naman namin pinagdadamot yung mga giveaway namin. As I mentioned, maliit lang ang kinikita namin dito, mas malaki pa yung gine-giveaway namin. Because guys, this is just for awareness para at least alam nyo kung ano yung binibili nyong unit. And speaking of awareness, in case you do have this type of unit, guys, just comment down below about your feedback on the unit, kung ano yung pwede mong i-share sa mga other customers. I think I said everything on this unit. Then again, this is Dustin from Laptop Factory. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.